So I was in that mode of being very hungry to rehearse and to learn. And that's really what you need, what you needed in a situation with Frank. Because with Frank, the rehearsals were, you have to be on. You just, there's no, you know, it's a big boy's game. You know, when Frank walks in, you just have to be on, you know. And I remember my audition, because he asked me to come down and learn all these songs. And obviously, when I got there, we didn't play any of the songs that he told me to learn, but I got through. But he says, you know, to me, okay, play this. And he picks up his guitar and he kind of cryptically plays a line, because Frank had a particular style and it wasn't of the virtuoso type nature, you know what I mean? It was more visceral, you know. So he plays through something, he goes, okay, now play this tempo. Okay. And you gotta get it right like that, or else, you know? So I say, okay, and I play it, you know, and there's all these guys around, and I'm 20 years old. And he says, okay, add this note here, and he plays a note. So I said, okay, and I thought about it, and I add the note. He goes, okay, now play it in 7/8. I said, okay, and I played it in 7/8, you know, and he goes, okay, now play it 7/8 reggae. And I thought for a minute, okay, and I play it in 7/8 reggae, you know, and it's this ridiculous line that has nothing to do with, should never be played on the guitar, you know. And then he goes, okay, now add this note. And I looked up at him, I said, it's impossible. Because it was. Nobody could do it, you know. And he goes, well, I hear Linda Ronstadt is looking for a guitar player. But, you know, having the that real focus at Berkeley in the rehearsal, definitely very valuable to me when I got to California and started rehearsing with Brian.